Okay guys, today we talk about exporting animation from Blender to Unrealengine 5 using Alembic Cache. But first of all, I have big news for you guys. Just look at that smile. No more braces. So we are here in the middle of my project with little robot here. What I did is that I used some modifier to animate this little spring here. Let me show you. And as you can see, here I just made few keyframes at the beginning of my timeline, but after I use modifier. When you do this in Blender, it's simple to have like a random pattern. I use like modifier here, you can see in the right hand side with simple deform, but I also use like my graph editor here. I just select it from there. And with my four keyframes here at the beginning, I just use like a modifier with cycles in order to repeat automatically these things and avoid putting one by one my keyframe. But when you do this in Blender, it's great, simple, straightforward. But when you try to export it, it might be difficult. When you have this kind of example, one of the best way is to use Alembic Cache, because what you see here, you can just export it as it is and use it directly in Unrealengine 5. So to do this, I just select my spring and I go to File, Export and use Alembic. Here, we're gonna give it a name like Bullet Spring. One thing important to know here before exporting our spring is to change the scale. If you leave it as 1 in Unrealengine 5, we will have a tiny model. So tiny that it might occur some problems. So the best is to put it at 100. Scene options, you can leave it as default here, but just select the only selected objects in order to avoid exporting all the scene. And here at the bottom, we don't have particle system and just export Alembic. So now let's open Unrealengine 5 and import this animation. Here we have my scene with my little robots, and now we will import our Alembic Cache. So I open my content drawer and just go to import from here. I go and search for my robot spring here, points ABC. And here you will have this window appearing. And if you pay attention, you will have a bunch of settings. If you have this little tick with circle, because this is a primitive I did in Blender, it didn't rename it, it detected again as it is. I have the start and end frame corresponding to my Blender file here. So to 1 and 250. And most important here is the import type. We have three different types possible. So static mesh, geometry cache, and skeletal. Here we'll focus on geometry cache. And for the rest, you can leave it as defaults. It's working great. Just make sure you have the conversion on Autodesk Maya with the flip V activated, scale and rotation. As we did our little scale change with 100 during the export in Blender, you don't have to modify scale anymore. Just on one axis to put a minus in order to flip your model, because what you will often have when you try to import Alembic Cache is that you will have your objects rotated in a wrong way or flipped. So now we just can import it as it is. And now we have our little spring in our content drawer. Just remember, if you have this little star here in the bottom left side, it's just that Unrealengine is telling you to save your assets. So select and just press Ctrl S. If I double click it to see a little bit in detail, you won't have like a preview, like a classic static mesh or skeletal mesh in Unrealengine. We will just have some basic details, just the materials and a track. But when you use Alembic Cache in Unrealengine, the main point is just have a workflow really straightforward from your blender to your Unrealengine. And if I just drag and drop here, first thing you see is that my pivot point has a little offset. When I export it in Blender, you can see that it will always try to find the world origin of your scene in Blender. When you export from Blender, please try to remember that the origin of your model in Unrealengine will often be the world origin of your scene in Blender. Even if you apply transform, most of the time it will be at the center in the world origin, where you can see here your cursor. So what you can do in Unrealengine to avoid these kind of offsets that might be annoying is just to Alt middle click, drag your gizmo, and when you have your gizmo where you want, you just can right click, go to pivot and set as pivot offset. And now when you deselect it and reselect it again, your gizmo will be on point. You have another option here, is to select your model and go to modeling, go down and assign a new pivot point. But as you can see here with the geometry cache, you can do it because it's animated, it's really particular. But if you have like more a skeletal or a static mesh, you can use this modeling tool mod in Unrealengine in order to change or assign a new pivot point. And as you can see, my spring is not well oriented, but it's referring to what I just said earlier. Like when you have the convention, just try to match the axis that is not corresponding. But here for our example, it's just quick and easy to just move around and rotate our geometry cache like we want. And if you want to check the animation directly in your viewport, you can just select your spring, go to detail panel. In here in a start time offset, if you play around with detail timeline, you can see that it's animated. So that's great. But in order to use it correctly, what you can do is just create your level sequence in order to render your scene and put this geometry cache in a track in your sequencer. Let me just show you. So if you open your content drawer, right click, go to cinematics. We are here on the 5.1 Unrealengine version. And we can name it as spring tests. So I will just open my LS spring test. I can just click here to create a new and quick camera. Here, I can change my manual focus to avoid a too blurry render. And what I can do now is just to select my spring, go to plus track, add the actor to sequencer. The actor that you have selected just before will appear in the first top list. And here, so we call our actor into our sequencer, but now we have to call the animation itself. So when you select your buttering, just go to plus track and just select the geometry cache. If you press play, I have my animation using geometry cache in my sequencer. So guys, I hope that will help you in your workflow in order to avoid spending too much time trying to export imports from Blender to Unrealengine. Just remember that if you did a lot of job on Blender and you try to export it and use it as it is in Unrealengine 5, just think about the Alembic cache. It might be a great solution for you, just to put it after in the sequencer as we did. Let me know if you found it useful in the comments. If you have other tips in this kind for exporting animation from Blender, don't hesitate to share with everyone in the comments. And if you have other tips to share with me, I'm glad and will be happy to hear it. I will leave you at work now and just have a nice Blender and Unrealengine 5 export import time, and see you. Bye bye.